Red tide specifically is caused by a species of algae named Karenia brevis. And when these algae reproduce very, very quickly, they turn the water red or reddish brown. And so that's what we here on the Texas coast know as a red tide.
Record-breaking heat and drought has contributed to one of the longest outbreaks of red tide in Texas history. Red tide can be irritating to the skin and lungs, but is not a serious threat to most people.
Red tide does cause toxins that kill fish and are collected in the oyster tissue. And so, unfortunately, the commercial oyster season that would have began on November 1st has been suspended indefinitely.
The ongoing drought makes things even worse. With high salinity levels and little freshwater inflow into the bays, parasites and disease are also affecting oysters and other shellfish. However, oysters are filter feeders, and a single oyster can filter 50 gallons of water a day. So with clean water, they will rid themselves of toxins.
What has to happen is for the toxin level in the oyster meat to drop below a certain threshold level. But unfortunately, the drought is predicted to persist at least through early spring, mid-spring. And so that would typically be about the length of our commercial oyster season.
One bright side to the shutdown is that the remaining oysters will be allowed to grow and spawn in the spring. And Texas Parks and Wildlife has spent $4.5 million to restore oyster reefs with tons of river rock after Hurricane Ike.
When oysters spawn, their larvae will attach to this. This, we found, is very good material for that. We're putting down about 20 acres out in this site. We put it down about 5 inches of material on the bay bottom.
And with man helping Mother Nature, the oyster comeback is just a matter of time. For Texas Parks and Wildlife, this is Lydia Saldana.